be afraid. Kenny does tank the first few turret, not turret shots, sorry, but dragon shots, and it will be the first dragon. 3 minutes, 11 seconds in. Faster. They take a little bit more time.
There they go, they pile straight through. There's the flash.
Flash rocket jump slows down Lorla. They exhaust Kenny, though. They want him as the target. Annie, of course, has already lost her flash. They know that, and they give the kill away. Almost Otter. It's actually Flares who gets it. Enemy start out well.
Enemy with the early game pressure matching I do that every time. Counter Logic Gaming Black. But look at this in the mid lane, not to be outdone. No flash.
Cleanses away the root, but guess what? It's a lot of damage coming in towards Inox. He's the guy who cleansed, and Easy gets the kill. A quick trade back. Think Card's here as well. It's going to be a 4v4. Easy wants in. He does have his flash.
Well, there they go.
Gets on in, gets a two man knockup. They keep going for this one, but will it be enough damage? Easy's going to lose his life for this one. Otter got the reset on the rocket jump. The binding hits. Lorlo's in a really bad spot. He's going to go down as well. Do they want Think Card on top of this one? No, I'm just a 2-for-0, so CLB heavily overextend. Yeah. That's why they die so darn slowly. But now the first one does go down. The recall for Otter goes for Lorlo. Yeah, Lightning Rush is used through the binding. Ultimate in! Nice! Otter knew the damage. And here we go.
Yep. Easy had to back too. So they know Lissandra's not around. They know that Annie is about half HP or was, so he's ticking up on some potion. Immediately get this for themselves and even the dragon score. Bottom, that's the thing. They put their numbers there. Otter's trying to get this turret. Easy and Think Card. Trying to show up. Oh!
Wow, the black shield comes out in time. Easy gets hit with the Q. Trashy can't get the ult. There we go. Gets it, but Think Card should trade back. Exhausted heal keeps him safe. Think Card almost stunned under the turret. In comes Lorlo. Puts on the slicing maelstrom. Wants body drop. Gets him. TP's come in. Kenny and Graves are there. Trashy goes down to Tibbers. It's a 2-for-1 CLG Black.
He's just been focusing on his own play at the moment. We do see Jarvan still off on the side, though. They're going for Lorlo.
Wow, insta burst. They know the ult and flash are down. They chop him out. Bot lane's going to fall pretty easily.
That 278 crit allows her to just make that 100% increase on the 4 hits. Just even more. It's ridiculous how much damage she's going to do to turrets.
There's the teleport in from Kennen. Lissandra's going to show up as well.
Oh, he goes straight through.
Goes in, gets kicked back over by both of them. But Trashy walks a little bit back into range. Otter gets stunned. And Annie comes in with the Timbers. They kill out the AD carry. Trashy falls as well. The AoE comp might be working. But yeah, Victor's got something to say. Trades one back. But it's a 3-for-1 so far. Make that 3-for-2. 2-for-2 now, actually, as another couple of champions fall down. And that fight's a wash. Down.
What is Trashy doing? He's off on the side. There's the TP in to the back line. Are they going to start this?
Looks like
Flares is going.
Flares jumps in onto Lorlo. The battle begins. Inox getting jumped on right away. Almost exploded. Can get the ulti off, but they do trade back right away. Two members down from CLG Black. Sticks a forced run, but not before he takes down body drop. But in comes Otter. The cavalry's here. Trashy misses the flash. Otter does not. 5-for-2 enemy. Not matter. First couple respawns come in. Think Card is walking across the map, but he will not arrive in time to steal away Baron, I don't think. Enemy esports are going to get Baron off of that clutch team fight. Down it goes, and out they head. No, that's a death. That is a very real death. Think Card, what are we going in for?
Too.
He's trying again. The Victor Burst comes out, and it might just trade back. It does. But mid laner for jungler is pretty worth it.
Just the durability there on Inox with the black shield on top of everything just makes it so hard to kill him. And he's able to take out Think Card at the same time. But look at that, Kenny face checks.
He's caught. Warding goes down right away to the top laner and the jungler. Baron buffed up enemy esports. Looking to push mid. Right, Jarvan's back up right now. It is a 4v4.
They're
how long
chunk this turret, though.
Does enemy want to stay? They're going to stay for Lorlo, but he pops the zonings without ulti, which means they can get him right back afterwards. No stun comes out from Kennen. Will they stay for the turret? Looks like the answer is yes.
This is desperation.
But who cares? It's a Lee Sin jungle with plenty of tank items. Doesn't take any meaningful damage from Easy. Now the inhibitor under fire. It's a 4v4 again as Kenny respawns. He's charged up the stun. Enemy walks out with some buffed up minions. Enemy to get pushed around with. Bot lane is open. There's the TP flank one
Same
more time
spot.
From Kennen.
Can't go in.
Make it happen. Goes in, kicked back towards Otter. Can he pop the Zonias? Yes, he can. He gets some really meaningful damage, but Think Card already blows up to Victor. It's a 1-for-0. Body drop trades back with the enemy jungler, and he got more happening now. 3-for-1 already. Easy force to run. There's just no damage left on CLG Black. And that's going to be the fourth kill of the fight.
And the main damage dealers are staying alive for a prolonged time, and they're such high damage at this point.
Yeah, you're forced to engage in on Victor and Tristana, and Maokai sucks at the damage as I dare you to. Works out beautifully so far. Enemy esports looking at a double inhibitor take off of that team fight. They didn't go for dragon. They wanted the base to die. Now they can drag on the retreat, but with double inhibitors down, This is Enemy's Esports game to lose. You TP into a ward and try rush above them and walk down the river. Not gonna happen. Enemy Esports, they get themselves Baron number two this game.
Devote their body to getting all the way up there.
No,
and their front line.
Begins.
Oh, there's the engagement flares onto Stixxay.
Righteous Glory. Yep, gonna lock up Stixxay. Just buy some time. The turret's already dead. Kenny's got a charge on his head. They re-engage. They blow up Otter. Think card's pretty low for this, though. Lorlo also taking a lot of AoE. Inox kites back safely. His ult is gonna claim the second kill for himself this fight. It's a 2-for-1 so far. CLB did decent, but Easy's now in the wrong spot. That's gonna be a quick kill picked up. A double for Inox in this one. Minions inside the base as well. This could be the game-winning push if they're willing to stick it out. Triple inhibitor down. Difficult enough for them. Mid and hip goes back down. Bottom hip going to be refocused. It actually already has super minions because of how the minion waves were managed before, so they can ride this wave directly into the base potentially.
And if it's not this wave, it's the one in the top lane too. They're just taking so much turret damage here. It's the final stand.
There we go. Next turret number one. There's the engage. Think card does not reach Otter. He's going to blow up first. Already a 2-for-0. This is going to be a very clean and easy fight for Enemy Esports. Everyone kites out safely. 5-for-0, a triple kill for Inox. That's gonna be the Nexus. 2-0, Enemy Esports.
What? Still the team to beat. Quadra kill for Inox on Victor. This guy was playing Nidalee for the longest time. Pulls out a Kassadin, a Xerath, a LeBlanc, an Ahri, and now a Victor?